As of May 11th of 2025, there are currently 49 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 3 less than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes, representing North America's tallest actively erupting volcano, can be found a mere 70 kilometers southeast of Mexico City. There, the summit of the 22-kilometer-wide Great-Top Popocatepetl volcano towers to an impressive height of 5,393 meters or 17,694 feet. Popocatepetl has been near continuously erupting since 1994, largely producing Vulcanian and sometimes Strombolian explosions. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Indonesia, magma apparently moved underneath a portion of a major city, heading south then into the magma conduit of the Iya Volcano. Meanwhile, in Hawaii, Kilauea produced another episode of intense lava fountaining, but this time it was its shortest so far of the year. And, in what is this week's top story, a semi-unexpected volcanic eruption occurred offshore of southern Mexico, sending a sizable volume of fresh basaltic lava onto the ocean floor. This occurred approximately 900 kilometers south-southwest of the city of Acapulco at approximately 2,500 meters or 8,202 feet below sea level. This did not occur at a central peaked volcano, although you can see remnant volcanic cones nearby. Instead, it originated from a raised submarine volcanic ridge that marks the boundary between the Pacific Plate to the west and the Cocos Plate to the east. This marks one of the 771 segments that comprise the 65,000-kilometer-long network of mid-ocean ridges that exist around the planet. These mid-ocean ridges represent divergent tectonic plate boundaries which over time slowly spread apart, allowing for distinct segments of them to erupt via fissures and form new oceanic crust. Mid-ocean ridges are thus responsible for all of the planet's oceanic crust, which is made of basalt, erupting at an average rate worldwide of 602 meters per second. This adds up to a whopping 19 cubic kilometers of basalt lava worldwide each year. Such mid-ocean ridge eruptions are responsible for an average of 75% of all lava erupted worldwide each year, and one occurred between April 28th and April 29th this year was one such eruption near a hydrothermal vent called Tycho that is located at these coordinates. We know that this eruption occurred as multiple scientists were performing daily dives in a submersible to the Tycho hydrothermal vent, and while on April 28th there was a healthy underwater ecosystem, the following day, everything was dead, the water had elevated temperatures, and fresh basaltic lava and its glow could be observed. The dive was immediately cancelled at that time, and everyone returned safely to the surface. This marks the fourth well-documented eruption of this specific ridge segment, with other eruptions occurring twice in 1991 and once in 2005. Meanwhile, in Hawaii, this week saw Kilauea produce its 20th recent episode of intense lava fountaining. Since December 23rd of 2024, Hawaii's most currently active shield volcano has been producing a fairly predictable cycle of activity which is shown on screen. The 20th such episode began on May 5th at 10:48 a.m., initially consisting of weak and occasional overflows of its two active craters, marking a process known as gas pistoning. This process repeated more than 30 times on May 5th, and the following day activity progressively increased. Occasional low-level and dome fountains then occurred before escalating to full fountaining at 5:28 p.m. on May 6th. Continuous lava fountains then rose to a height of 500 feet, continuing for multiple hours straight. For the first 30 minutes, an average lava fusion rate of 200 cubic meters per second was observed. However, activity eventually started to subside, and by 9:58 p.m. it had ended. This intense fountaining phase was the shortest of the 20 recent Kilauea episodes by nearly a factor of 2. And, in Indonesia, an uptick in activity once again occurred at the Iya Volcano, which is situated at the edge of and just south of the city of End, population 89,000. Iya consists of 3 volcanic cones, although only the southernmost has erupted in historical times. Iya has been displaying signs of unrest since October of last year, involving a magmatic intrusion which eventually failed. It appears that another such intrusion began on May 4th, but strangely, magma originated not from directly below Iya's cone, but rather from what must be a previously unknown magma chamber beneath the Magma cone. Located at 7 kilometers depth, this magma moved horizontally to enter Iya's magma conduit, rising slightly and sending large volumes of gas upwards to create a sustained white gas plume. Activity has since decreased, but with a theoretical potential for the magma supply to resume, Iya is currently at an alert level of yellow. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on May 10th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Pontoon, for supporting my work.